will be great. It is possible. You have heard so much and you are wondering, all these songs you are talking about now, how are you going to do it? Is it possible? I have children in school, I am married, I have aged parents. How am I going to cope with this issue of greatness? But I'm here to tell you that greatness is possible. Greatness has to entail. What is greatness? We've been calling greatness. It has to do with being successful in life. A great person is an achiever. We've just heard about the Achievers Club. A great person is a person that is recognized and appreciated in the society. That's a great person. A great person is a person that is prosperous. It's well to do too. And so greatness here does not really mean flowing in money. Take note. When we're talking about greatness, we're not talking about flowing in money, but flowing in wealth. There's a difference between being rich and being wealthy. Oh my God, when I discovered this, I know that many people do not know the difference. So what's the difference between being rich and being wealthy? Because we said that greatness is not flowing in money, but flowing in wealth. So what is the difference between riches, a rich man, and a wealthy man? I'm just going to read few, I don't have time, I don't know, I don't know what I mean. A rich person is a person that has plenty of money. And he may have gotten that money from inheritance. Maybe the parents died, and they are handing over the money of the parents to him or her. And you see the dad living big, driving big car, staying in a big house. But it's called that after a while, because he did not know how that money was made, a time will come in his life that he will come almost go back to square one. So the difference is in duration. A wealthy man is a man that has money and lives in money, in affluence, and is also a blessing to a society. That I think I like that one. You don't just have money, go to Asia and eat food, enjoy yourself, carry women, go to top right, go on holiday in South Africa, and you're not impacting the life of anybody. You are not a great man. Take note of that. A great man or a great woman is a person that is blessed and is a blessing. They are a great person. So how can I become great so that I will all be a blessing to my generation? We are going to look at that very, very quickly. So greatness here tells us on how to achieve what you choose to achieve in the area you wish to achieve it. You know, in life, there are different areas that you actually be a great person. For example, I'm an academician. My greatness is in academics. You could be a great person in your business. You could also be even a great person in marriage. Say, that couple, they have a great marriage. Are you a minister of God? The Lord has called me into the ministry. Are you just there to collect on the arrow? You just want to become a invitation, you just talk, and at the end of the day, they give you money, you go, you don't even get to know whether the word that you carry there has impacted any life. You're not a great person. A great minister of God is a minister of God that's always expecting results. When you have minister, you pray, God, do something. And what gives you joy as a true man of God is the lives of people that God has touched through you. Essentials of greatness. What are the things you and I need to do if I want to be great? If you want to be great, we are going to take them one by one. I'm a professional teacher and I'm going to be fast. You are going to push me to be fast. Now I've taught you as I have to do to my students. Okay? A lot of factors going into creating a great life. Plenty, plenty factors. To create a great life, many things are put into it. Okay? Your woman cannot create what your mind cannot conceive. Take note of that. It's what your mind is able to conceive that come into physical manifestation that people see and they say you are a great man. You are a great woman. I had a passion for education and I got married at 22 years. I graduated in my husband's house, but that passion did not die because I had that passion that I want to be this person to be able to reach my generation, especially the young ones and love students. One thing you must take note of, hey, greatness is a journey. I'm going to suffer. You are going what? On a journey. Greatness is not a destination. You don't jump into it. You go little by little. It's a process. It's a journey. It's a journey of a thousand miles. That's what? One step. I appreciate the fact that you have the knowledge where we are. They are jumping the task. It could be tasks like, for example, you are smarting as losing your weight. Maybe today you are weighing 90 as a woman and you are struggling. Can I lose my weight? I like your dress and look smart. You can do it. You start small. Be determined. Make up your mind. Say, I have what it takes to do it. Help me. You wake up in the morning. You do 5 minutes. In the afternoon, you do 5 minutes. In the space of 1 year, you discover that that weight that you are seeing, you are thinking it's not possible to do anything about. The thing with God, because you are the time. And you know that you have what it takes. All you need is for you to make up your mind. Greatness starts with a desire. Do you want to be great? As you are sitting here, it's a desire. I don't just want to be like everybody. There's something inside of me that telling me you're not just like. And I turn into prayer, say God, I don't just want to be like the multitude. Remove me from the level of the multitude. So greatness starts with a desire. If you desire greatness, the greatness will be available to you. Two, be hungry for greatness. Our friend Daniel that spoke to us told us that he was hungry. When he see the people coming and they are living really good, eating and they are overing there, there was a hunger in his spirit to be great. If you are not hungry for greatness, you can't be great. A positive attitude towards your vision. What is your vision? Your vision is your dream, your goal. What you want to achieve in life is your vision. I believe that we are sitting here, we desire something. I think it's the pursuit that is the problem. But here, we say number two says, desire greatness. And if you desire greatness, then develop a positive attitude towards it. Desire that you deserve all the good things of life. There was a time in my life I said, God, I did not just come to the world and watch people living good life. I'm not a spectator. I refuse to just come and see people drive good cars, live in good houses, and I'm just, life is just going. God, I also want to enjoy the good things of life. So calculated risk. Take a chance. Free yourself from the mediocre mind. Who is a mediocre? A mediocre is a person that set us for anything. And by giving it that this one God give me said, he do for me. You are a mediocre. Some of us will stay in one room and power up for 10 years. you are still there, you have a mediocre mind. You are not desiring greatness. And so because the desire is not there, you are comforting your room and problem. You are not doing anything about it to move from there. But if you desire greatness, you become very uncomfortable. After 1 or 2 years, what am I still doing here? And that's what is going to motivate you to work hard. Hard work. Okay? Shut the door of your mind, your life voices, telling you it is not possible. And open it to the tiny voice, saying it is possible. If you don't give up, halfway to greatness. Sometimes you get serious in the middle of possible, either from the television, either from your parents, or from your friends. Shut your mind to those voices, telling you it is not possible. Pursue your dream. Then three, do something about your desire for greatness. As long as I said that greatness is a journey, then I went on to talk about desire greatness. And I'm talking about now that you have desired greatness, do something about it. It's not enough to desire to be rich. What am I going to do to be a wealthy person? Very, very important. Do something. Three basic things you need to do. One, know exactly what you want. What is it that you want from life? Sit down and ask yourself, what do you want from life? The Lord will make a way for you to walk towards it. That is it. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. Have the right people around you. I've talked about so much I've said, and I don't want to repeat myself. Always follow a straight line. Focus. If you want to be, for example, now you just have school sats, and you want to earn a degree. Not the current girlfriend, they are distraction. Even if they are young, be focused on where you are a boy and a girl. Be focused on where you are going. That small money that you are getting for your tomatoes and your pepper, you'll be using it to cook for somebody. Instead of reserving the money to go first, do job and go and do your degree. You are busy servicing one person. Improve yourself. So what have you said about improving? You want to be great? Now you are a tailor. New things are coming up. The old tailor. People are doing bidding. And somebody bring a club to me and say, "Father, please, I want to do bidding on my class." He said, "I don't like to do bidding, no." And you are telling her, you see people doing bidding. What you can learn how to do so that when they come to you, you'll be able to pay for them. The world is leaving some of us behind. The world is leaving some of us behind. We just refuse to upgrade. That is the reason for this program. Upgrade yourself. Improve on yourself. Take note of it. Are you a fashion design? Fashion? Think of your boss when they do that. Different design. And you are still with your old method. You are not upgrading yourself. The world is going to leave you behind. Okay? Then number four. Refuse to give up. I have just spoken on do something about your what? Your desire. Do something about your desire. Don't just sit down and lie to happen. What you hold a degree? You cannot just sit down and one day you become a degree holder. Walk towards it. There are people who cannot complete to get money to go to school. They are walking towards what? Greatness. Greatness. And of course, refuse to give up. If you are not accountable, you cannot be a great person. One more right now, come into your hands and find the view. And you cannot even say what you use it for. You can't be a great person. So whatever you are doing, whether it's in business, whether it's in a concrete, I want to start at the small level. Whether it's in a sales gear, or whether it's this small thing. Take record of the things you are doing. It will help you to know whether you are making progress or not. If you are not making progress, improve on yourself. Very, very important. The great energy physical or visual cobalt. You know, sometimes in our churches, when they want to build a house, they will put the picture of the building. They put in front of the church. When you go to this, this church for this one, find you. We can get a good building store and enter. That becomes a kind of a motivator. You can put a picture just from the net of the person who has graduated in your room and say, "Wow, what am I going to get this kind of guy?" I like it. And you are smiling inside your room, nobody knows why you are smiling. Because you have seen something that is what? Inspiring you. You need that. Something that will inspire you. You need to put it somewhere that you see it every day. Ah, this is beautiful. I know that when they will get there, it's a matter of time. And that becomes a motivator. When you have something like that, you cannot easily be distracted. What is your strength? What is your mission? Why did God create you? Why did God create me? I don't believe that God just woke up and told my mother to just give birth to me. He must have a very good reason. He brought me to planet Earth for a purpose. He also brought you to planet Earth for a purpose. And that purpose for you to be great, to be a blessing to yourself, to your family members, to those living in your compound, to your church, to the society in general. I pray that the Lord will give us the grace. And as we are living here, we live here angry. I've gone for a program and I go home very angry. Sometimes that night I don't sleep. I say, God, do something about my life. I can't continue like this. I pray that as you are living here, you are going to live here angry. Say, God, I also want to be great. Those men and women that came and they talk, they don't have the go ahead. They are just like me. Whatever made them to be like that, I need it. Open my eyes to see, open my heart to see. And I believe that this night, you will get the revelation of greatness and you will be great. The awareness will be gathered. It is you who will be listening to it in Jesus' name.